Hello, welcome back to my channel. If you would like to use your DSLR camera as a webcam, then this video is for you. I will show you how to connect it to your computer using a generic HDMI video capture device I picked up on Amazon and tested in OBS and Zoom. If interested, please continue watching. If you find the video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Now, let's get to the video. Hello, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will be reviewing this HDMI video capture that I picked up on Amazon. I'm gonna connect it to my Nikon camera and also try it in OBS and see how it works. These are the different features. I hope you can see it. If not, I will expand it and or enlarge it so you can see it in the video. But according to the specifications or some of the features here, it says that the video capture can capture both HDMI video and HDMI audio. So it looks like it's a pretty good deal here. Also, it supports input maximum resolution of 4K. So a lot of people are using that resolution for their YouTube video. So I've opened it already because I just wanted to see how this works. So it comes in this little pouch. So here we have the little unit. It's pretty solid, not cheap plastic, so it's pretty cool. So you have the USB A in this side, and you also have that HDMI port on the other side. It comes with the USB extension cable, and also it comes with the manual. So this is supposed to be straightforward. I'm just gonna test it out and see how it works. So right now I am going to connect it to my camera. So let's check it out. Okay, I have my camera here. This is my Nikon D3300. I also have the micro HDMI cable for this. So I will be connecting this end. So let's come to this side. Let's open up the video outputs here. And I will be using this output here. So I just plug it in. That goes there. And the other end will go to the HDMI capture. Like that. Now we're going to connect this to the computer. Now let's check OBS. Okay, now that we set up the camera to the HDMI video capture and it's connected to the computer, now we're going to use OBS to recognize the camera, the DSLR camera, so we can use it as a webcam. So in OBS, I'm going to create a scene. So I'm going to go to scene selection, new. I want to call it, I don't know, HDMI video capture. You can call it whatever you like. Well, under scenes, I'm going to leave it like that. I'm just going to add the sources to the scene. So here I'm going to create or set up or add a video capture device. Video capture device. I'm going to rename it to DSLR and click OK. And then from here, it's pointing to my webcam, but I don't want my webcam. Okay, hello, welcome. Here I am using my DSLR Nikon D3300 as a webcam in OBS. So I'm not sure if you're noticing, but there is a little delay between the audio and the video, but we're gonna fix that now. Okay, so let's take a look. From here, from the audio mixer, I'm gonna click on this little wheel at the bottom. I'm going to click on Advanced Audio Properties, and then right here under Audio Input Capture, I'm going to change the sync offset settings to 220 and okay it. And now I am going to turn on my camera. Let's see if that will fix my little issue, and if not, I will have to just restart OBS and come right back. Okay, so we'll be back. So welcome back. It looks like that little fix in the audio settings took care of that delay issue that I had between the video and the audio. So now I am going to turn on my DSLR camera, and as you can see, everything is working well. If you face this similar issue, then go right ahead and go into your audio settings and tweak that little setting where your microphone is, and then you would avoid this issue. Now, if you don't want to go through all this setup and headaches, then I would recommend you connecting your microphone directly onto your camera, so this way you would avoid this issue in your final product. Okay, so this is not an OBS tutorial, this is just a quick tip if you face this problem in OBS. So right now we're going to take a look at a test in Zoom. So once you set up your DSLR camera as a webcam, you can use it in any other videos that you would like to use it as a webcam. And you can also use it for teleconferencing, whether it's in Microsoft Teams or in Zoom. This would work perfectly as well. All you have to do is locate your source, your video source, and you'll be all ready to go. Okay, so here's a test in Zoom. I am going to go to my settings. And I move this in, you would see that it's, if I go to video, and here my camera is recognized under USB video, and here I am using my DSLR camera, Nikon D3300, as a webcam in Zoom. Okay, as you saw, this setup was tested in OBS and in Zoom. You can see on the right of me, I have my webcam. Just so you can see that I'm using my DSLR camera right here as a webcam for this recording. Okay, so as for the final review for this process and the setup, you will need, of course, your DSLR camera, a mini HDMI cable for your camera, or the cable that came with your camera. Also, you will need an external microphone. You will need OBS. OBS is a free software that you can download from the internet and install it on your computer. Once in OBS, you can you need to create a scene, and you also need to create a source. One source for your camera and another source for your microphone. Of course, this is not an OBS tutorial. As far as the performance of the video capture, it is a plug-and-play device. As soon as I plugged it into my computer, Windows 10 detected it immediately. I did not have to install any drivers at all. The only cons that I found was the little delay between the audio and the video, and I was able to fix that in the settings once I went into the audio input capture settings, and I was able to change the one of the settings there. That took care of the problem. In terms of the price, it was $17.99 at the time of purchase back in February of 2021. So I don't know what the price is today. You would have to check on Amazon or wherever you get your products from. Would I recommend it? Yes, I would recommend it. I mean, it's for less than $20, you have a video capture that you can use with your DSLR camera for whether your live streaming or your video conferencing. So I think it's a great value and a good deal for this kind of setup. So this is it. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and be well.